points. 3 for 6 coming from the three-point line.
So some good contributions all around for the Lady Bees and their ability to pull off the win last night against the Ryerson Rams squad. Both Voyageurs teams actually successful last night. The men's Voyageurs team upsetting the number 6 seed in the country, Ryerson Rams, with a buzzer-beating shot by Mandy Pasquale. Great finish for both basketball games, and both teams look to continue that tonight as we're underway now here at the Ben Avery. Starting lineups now, starting for the University of Toronto Varsity Blues, Joe Stratton. That's number 6, number 8, Jasmine Lewin. Number 12, Leanne Bailey. Number 13, Rachel Sider. And rounding up starting for the Blues, 14, Amanda Lozak. And for the hometown Lady Bees, we've got number 5, Adrienne Moreau. Number 7, Kristen Patrick. Number 8, Danielle Harris. Number 15, Emma DeCore. And number 21, Emily Chemcha. I'm Kirby Johnson alongside Mike Hall. You've got OUA basketball on East Lake TV, and we're happy to have you with us as the Varsity Blues off to a quick 4-0 lead.
And Laurentian Lady Bees got to do a better job today than they did yesterday in their zone. The zone got picked apart by the Ryerson Rams team, and it looks like the Toronto Blues are really on the front foot tonight, really trying to take it to this Lady B team without Sasha Polichuk.
And it'll be difficult tonight, Mike, to have any other focal point of conversation other than the absence of Sasha Polichuk from the Lady B's lineup. He's been such a crucial and important player for them all season long, and now, as you said, they're going to have to find some other ways to do some scoring. It looks like the Varsity Blues have done a bit of research here and checked their scouting reports. They've got a bit of a full-court press going on early on in recognition that Polichuk isn't there to use her calmness and maturity to dribble out of those tough situations.
Yeah, that's a great call by head coach of the Toronto Blues, making that read and applying that full-court pressure. There's not a lot of secondary point guards on this team. The Lady V struggle bringing it up the floor when Sasha Polichuk isn't on the floor, and as we've seen so far early in this game, they've struggled a bit with that full-court pressure by the Toronto Blues.
As another point of interest, on Breast Cancer Awareness Night, the Laurentian University event staff likes to use a pink basketball. It fits all the OUA and CIS standards, but the Varsity Blues were not supportive of this blue basketball for tonight's game, so here we are using the standard basketball that we're used to. As both free throws from the row are good, and the Varsity Blues back on the basketball. Nice pass inside, finding Lozo, who kicks it out. Stratton kicks it back inside. Nice pass to Lozo, who's at the mark of their shot. Well, a scramble for the rebound, now it's picked up by the row. And pass it back now the other way for Lady Bees. Finds the flow in the corner. Very closely by Lozo. Back up to Patrick. Setting a screen that opens up Danielle Harris. She takes an open look at three, and that one's good.
And the foul.
A great N1 opportunity for Danielle Harris earlier on in the game. That was a nice look at three-pointer. Good ball movement by the Lady Bees as well.
Yeah, great job by the Lady Bees on that one. Good job by Danielle Harris picking up where she left off yesterday. She had a big game off the bench, which I alluded to before, with 11 points, 4 for 10 from the field.
So it looks like that three-pointer is going to count, but there might have been a foul off the ball. Got a travel call against the Varsity Blues. Leanne Bailey with the turnover.
Looks like they called a foul off the ball on Emma DeClo.
After that three-pointer.
Yeah.
Tim Chuck getting the ball inbounds. Kicked away by Bailey. That's going to give Tim Chuck a fresh 5 seconds to inbound the ball. 8:09 to go in the first quarter. 5-4 for the Lady Bees after that three-pointer by Harris. It gets herself open nicely for the inbound play, but Patrick choosing the more difficult shot.
Good job by Timchuk coming back to the ball there.
Harris sets up the offense, and Timchuk takes an elbow in the chin. That's going to be Lozo picking up the foul. Timchuk a little shaken up.
Coach Mike Clark wants a big game out of Emily Timchuk tonight.
Sounds like Rocky over there right now. Colin Adrian. Patrick looking inbound now. Good inbound defense. Ball finds DeClo. She looks to go baseline on Lozo. Steps out of bounds. It's going to be Varsity Blues basketball. It's a nice move, just a little bit too close to the baseline.
Yeah, good aggressive drive there. Looked like she might have got bumped out of bounds, but referee's right on top of that one.
Varsity Blues quickly escaping the light pressure from the Lady Bees as the ball swung to the right side. Dipped into the middle out to Lozo. Ball underneath, open shot for Stratton, and that one drops through.
Good job dissecting that zone by Toronto Blues.
It does look as though the Varsity Blues picked up on the fact that Polishuk's not there to bring the ball into the backcourt, as you see a nice layup by Dutrow. But it looks like the Lady Bees have spent some time practicing probably today and this afternoon, breaking out of full court pressure. It looks like they're not having too many problems with that so far. As right back down the other way, I think we've got an and one opportunity. A nice finish by Jasmine Lewin. She's going to head to the line and look to complete the and one opportunity.
Yeah, Lady V's got to do a better job getting back on defense, accounting for open Toronto Blues. Can't give up too many layups in this game if they expect to stay in it, especially without their leader, fifth-year guard Sasha Polachek.
Score now 8-7 for the Varsity Blues. Three-pointers off the mark, so the score remains the same. And that one's tipped off the hands of Evan DeClos, and it's going to remain Varsity Blues basketball. They've got a fresh shot clock.
Yeah, Toronto Blues is second in the country in offensive rebounds with over 17 rebounds a game. So that's going to be key for the Lady Bees controlling their own defensive glass.
It's a nice inbound play by the Varsity Blues that opened up the wide open three for Stratton. She's just well off the mark, putting up the air ball. It's going to be Lady Bees basketball now. And Lady Bees getting the ball across half. Danielle Harris with it now. Set things up. A little pressure from Stratton. She's got Patrick in the corner. She's driving the left hand. Beautiful layup by Danielle Harris, taking it right to the rack, up off glass and through for two.
Yeah, fantastic move by Harris there. Just losing her check with the crossover. Going strong left. Finishing strong. Great move by Harris.
And nice pass inside. Tipped away by Kristen Patrick. We saw quite a lot of that last night. Mike Lady Bees with some very active hands, breaking up a lot of passes and coming away with a lot of steals.
Yeah, Lady Bees were very active last night. They had a couple lulls in that zone, but hopefully they can do a better job tonight with a little bit more consistent play.
The long range shot by the goals off the mark, back down the other way to the Varsity Blues. Dunn goes a little up off glass, and she's got herself a couple more points. Stratton now with six on the night. That's Jill Stratton, a fourth-year eligibility student in her first year at U of T. She's a kinesiology student from Brampton, Ontario. As Patrick, cross-court pass finding Harris in the corner. She goes baseline. Looking for the pass across to the goal. Off front of the Varsity Blues and out of bounds. It's going to remain Lady Bees basketball. They take it in the shot clock. A couple substitutions now. We've got Mary Scott checking in, as well as number 12, Aaron Simpson, checking out Emily Timchuk, and number 7, Kristen Patrick. Looks like number 11 for the Varsity Blues, Alicia Van Kempen, is going to check in. She's a 6'2", fourth-year phys ed student from Brampton, Ontario as well. Harris looking for somebody to open up. And that play broken up by the Varsity Blues, and it's back down the other way. A nice dribble by Stratton. And Mary Scott's going to pick up the foul on the nice drive by Van Kempen.
Yeah, great job by Jill Stratton there, really forcing the issue, getting out in transition, and then finding her teammate, slashing to the hoop.
So Varsity Blues team, so far anyway, like, seems to be communicating really well. They seem to move the ball very well. They seem to just know where each other's going. Looks like they're a squad that may have played a couple years together. They've got some veteran players looking down this roster. Only a couple first-year students. This is a squad that's had some time to develop some chemistry, and it looks like we're going to see a bit of that tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. They're looking very comfortable on offense against this soft Lady V zone. Lady V's are going to have to do a better job just picking up the intensity a little bit here, doing what they did last night, like what we talked about, being active, getting in the passing lanes and trying to disrupt passes.
Checking in now for the Varsity Blues, Alana Garner. She's going to take the place of number 8, Jasmine Lewin, who's going to take a seat for the first time tonight. Just inside 6 minutes to go. Score now 11 for the Varsity Blues, 9 for the Lady Bees. And the long pass over to Devin A. Bryce, picked off by the Varsity Blues, and back now the other way is Rachel Sider.
Back-to-back turnovers by Danielle Harris.
Well, one of those press break passes that the Lady Bees were looking was pretty much a wide-open cross-court pass, so the Varsity Blues didn't take too long to pick that up, Mike, and the Lady Bees have to adjust. As Danielle Harris drives down towards the corner, looking back up top, by Mary Scott. Brings it to DeClos in the corner. The baseline again, she's got two guards on her now. Looking to spin away, finds Harris on top of the three, shot clock inside 5 seconds. Mary Scott open for three, she gets that shot away. And it rims out, rebounded by DeClos. Lady Bees fresh shot clock. Danielle Harris takes no driving. Checks it out now to Simpson. Simpson goes up hard with the right hand, and she's fouled.
Great job by the Lady Bees on that possession right there. Being patient, passing the ball, offensive rebound, leading to a closeout opportunity, and Aaron Simpson attacking nice on the right-hand side, going strong to the hoop, being rewarded with two free throws. I know Coach Mike Clark is really expecting a big game out of Aaron Simpson tonight. She's a good secondary scorer for this Lady Bees, and they're going to need her tonight with no Sasha Polachek.
And we just saw Mary Scott put up her first three-pointer of the weekend, and we've seen her drain a few of those this year so far, Mike, so definitely growing some confidence there and expanding her range. Second free throw from Simpson. Good couple substitutions now in for the Lady Bees. Number 14, Mitchell McLean, in for Emma DeClos.
Yeah, good minutes out of Emma DeClos early in this game. She had some aggressive drives to the hoop. Doing a good job on the boards as well.
And checking in for the Varsity Blues for the first time, Julie Longow, 6 foot, sociology and equity student from Windsor. 3-point attempt. That one rims out, shot by Bailey. And Simpson taking hard to the ground.
Good job by Simpson, really sticking her nose in there, drawing the foul, getting the possession back for Lady Bees.
Looks like Jenna Davidson's going to check in now for Mary Scott. Saw Jenna Davidson light it up from beyond the arc a couple times last night. Mike, she was feeling pretty good in that Lady Bees victory.
Yeah, absolutely. 3-for-6 from the three-point line. She was exciting. A big up-and-coming player for the Lady Bees. Mike Clark had to be happy about her play of late and expect big things today as well.
Simpson looking for something from Davidson. Didn't quite work out for her, but ball finds Davidson on the left side, and she's good for three. Picks up right where she left off, Mike. 14-11 now for the Lady Bees. Left off the back on defense.
I can't give her any daylight. That's apparent. U of T got to do a better job finding her and making her a driver.
And a nice quick shot from Longauer inside. She's got her first 2 points of the night. 1 point game now. The Varsity Blues sitting on four fouls. Lady Bees with three. There's another one of those near suicide passes. Simpson managed to get there first. Jenna Davidson open from the same spot for three. And that one's good. 2-for-2 to start it off, and the Varsity Blues are going to call a timeout and try and cool her and this Lady Bees offense off. Jenna Davidson checks in, about 30 seconds onto the court, Mike, and she's got 6 points.
Yeah, Jenna Davidson is red hot, 5-for-8 in her last 8 shots in the past 2 games from three-point land. Once she gets going, she's going to be tough to stop. U of T got to do a better job keying on her, making her put the ball on the floor, making sure that she's not able to get a shot up, because when she does, it's lights out.
And it was an identical play back-to-back. The Varsity Blues just didn't pick up on it. I'm sure head coach Michelle Belanger is just letting her team know now that needs to be guarded a lot more closely than it is right now. From the exact same spot twice in a row, and it looks like she's feeling good again tonight. Like, look for a big performance from her. It looks like all these ADBs are ready to step it up and make up for the missing scoring of Sasha Polachuk tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. Head coach Mike Clark has to be thrilled with how his Lady B team has come out tonight in the absence of Sasha Polachuk. Danielle Harris especially inserted into the starting lineup, bringing a lot of aggressiveness early, going strong to the hoop, in the three, taking the reins of the point guard job, doing a pretty good job being patient, trying to break that zone. Mike Clark's got to be happy with the 17-13 lead with only 4:05 left in the first quarter.
And during that last timeout, you got a bit of a look at Sasha Polachuk standing next to head coach Mike Clark as he's drawing up the next play. And Polachuk showed up tonight on crutches, Mike, and she's day-to-day. We had a chance to talk to Mike Clark about it a little bit last night after the game. But she's day-to-day, and it's a strained right ankle. And as anyone who's ever sprained an ankle or broken an ankle knows, a sprain can be a lot more painful than a break can. So definitely taking some precautions tonight with Sasha, and they'll probably look to get her back in the lineup next week.
Yeah, I had a chance to speak with Sasha before the game, and she says it's a little sore, but they've done everything they can, icing it, wrapping it, and she expects to be back for next weekend.
Step-up jumper from Alana Gardner's off the mark. Offensive rebound goes to the Varsity Blues. They've got a new shot clock. And another step-up jumper. That one from Stratton. That one's off the mark, but another O-board. And Devonay Bryce going to get called for a foul. Lost control of herself midair.
Yeah, a bit of a wild play there by Devonay Bryce. But good job by Toronto there, being really relentless on the offensive glass. That's what they do well. Like I alluded to before, they're second in the country in offensive rebounds per game with over 17. Lady Bees got to be careful. They can't let too many offensive rebounds add up for Toronto. Can't give this dangerous team too many extra possessions in a game like this.
First free throw from Stratton's good. Get a look at Will. Second free throw's good, 3:44 to go in the first. You're listening to OUA basketball on Eastern TV. I'm Cody Johnson with Mike Poe.
Lady Bees hanging on to a two-point lead here, looking for back-to-back wins on this weekend, taking on the teams from Toronto. That's Ryerson and UNT. As Patrick finds Devin A. Bryce at the top of the three-point line. Shot clock inside 10. Bryce drives right. That one's going to drop in. Very nice little drive. Tough angle off glass, but she makes it count. And back in transition, now come the Varsity Blues. A nice cut step by Julie Longauer off the mark. We've got a late foul call here from the official. Longauer's going to head to the line.
A great job by Kristen Patrick, really being patient, bringing the ball up the floor against that zone. And then Devin A. Bryce going strong to the hole. Great job by the Lady Bees, but you got to do a better job getting back on defense. This Toronto team is looking to run. They're looking to get out and score quickly, and they got to do a better job getting back on defense and stopping penetration.
So Leanne Bailey checks out. Rachel Sider at back there. Or excuse me, Leanne Bailey into the game, and Rachel Sider takes a seat. First free throw from Longauer is good.
That was a great move by Longauer there, going right and then Euro stepping to the left.
Move that requires quite a bit of strength and agility. Like, you got to put all your weight down on that one knee and then push quickly back in the other direction. So a lot of strain on the joints.
Absolutely, and if you pull it off, it's a tough one to guard.
And that's a very wise attempt, a good attempt by Jenna Davidson. Looked like that pass setting on the bounce, tried to bank it off the UOT player. But UOT recovers, and they've got an opportunity to tie this game up now as Danielle Harris and Emma Nicole reset to check back in. Looks like McClain might have got a tip on that shot attempt, and the Lady D scores the turnover, and they're back the other way now. Simpson with it, looking at three, finds Bryce in the corner. Nice pass inside to McClain, she's got some time. Devin A. Bryce just stood there and let that ball go past. Not sure she knew what was happening. And that three-point attempt well off the mark by Patrick. Picked up by the Blues. Stratton driving in towards the lane. There's no help. Finds a teammate in the corner. That's Bailey. And Van Kempen with the shot over McClain. That one's good. We've got a tie game. Inside 2.5 to go here in the first quarter.
Good shot by Van Kempen right there. Just touching in the high balls. Turning, facing up. Seeing that the defender backed off and just teeing up a nice little mid-range jumper there. 19-19 now with just over 2 minutes to go in the first quarter.
And Devin A. Bryce with a nice drive right towards the hoop. That one's in and she's got an opportunity for 3 points. Looked like the Lady Bees are playing with fire a little bit around the center line there, Mike. Just kind of casually getting the ball across half. Looks like Devin A. Bryce might be a bit shaken up after hitting the floor pretty hard.
I think she took a shot right to the nose. Anybody. No, but great job by Devin A. Bryce coming out tonight, playing aggressive, going to the hole, really trying to pick up this scoring without Sasha Polachek, over 20 a game, but Lady Bees right now doing a good job, having a balanced scoring attack. Good job by Devin A. Bryce, Danielle Harris, Jenna Davidson. They're getting contributions all across the board. Mike Clark's got to be thrilled about the way the Lady Bees have come out today.
And Devin A. with the home court bounce and the free throw counts. Looks like we've got a turnover. U of T. Turning it over, trying to gain half. It's going to be Lady Bees basketball unless the officials overturn their decision. It's going to be Voyageurs basketball. A couple tactical fouls handed out last night, Mike. That's the first time we've seen that this season that I've seen, anyways. A couple of the coaches getting a little anxious towards the end of that Lady Bees Ryerson Rams game last night.
It was a big game, emotional game, too, going both sides.
Almost took out our monitor, Mike.
Almost. Lots of action. We got good seats right now.
JP 14. Substitutions now for the Varsity Blues. Stratton checks out. Kristen Patrick inbounds to Danielle Harris. She's got a wide open Jenna Davidson.
It looks like Toronto has fallen back into a 2-3 zone there.
And Danielle Harris with a bit of clumsy play. Had an open Davidson for three at the start of that possession and then tossed the ball out of bounds towards national rowing champion Carling Zeman.
Danielle Harris is doing a good job tonight, playing aggressive and filling in for the hurt Sasha Polachek, but she's got to do a little bit better job taking care of the basketball. She had a few careless turnovers early in this game.
That was a great sequence of passing from the Varsity Blues.
Looks like a traveling call.
Well, a nice play and a nice finish gone to waste. Some beautiful passing to guys. Dissect that Voyageurs defense, but a travel on the play, and it's Lady Bees ball. With it now. We've got a minute and a half to go in the first quarter. Floater off glass, no good. Goes for the offensive rebound, but it's pulled down by Lewin as she pushes things the other way. Finds Garnett. Back up to Lewin. Nice pass inside for Bailey. Kick out, tough shot off balance. Making that one look easy with Julie Longauer.
having a good first quarter. Longhour's got four now to go along with one foul.
That was a very impressive possession there by the Varsity Blues. Really taking their time, being aggressive, attacking that zone and finding a wide open shooter right there.
Nice crossover from Harris to gain up. Patrick with it now. We're kind of on the shot clock. Inside a minute to go. Harris for three. And that one right through the Lady Bees. On fire from beyond the arc tonight, Mike.
Great job by Harris. She's up to 8 points right now. She's playing very aggressive. She's playing with a lot of confidence. It's fun to watch this Lady B team right now.
40 seconds to go in the quarter. Varsity Blues swinging the ball around the perimeter. And that beautiful pass. Oh, and I don't know about that one. Mike, it looked like Devin A. Bice got almost all ball there.
Yeah, it looks like she was behind her. Maybe got her with the body a little bit. But Lady B's got to do a better job at the back of that zone. They struggled a bit last night with that zone, with their rotations. I had a chance to talk to Mike Clark last night, well, we both did, about the zone, and he said that they all know what they're doing. They just need to maintain focus throughout the possession. They just have mental breakdowns there at the end, and when the shot clock's running down, they got to do a better job maintaining focus.
Adrian Moreau said to check back in after the first free throw from Longhour was good. Or excuse me, that's Bailey. Second one's good as well. Moreau's going to check in for the Lady Bees. We've got 37.3 to go. Devin A. Bryce checking out for the rest of the quarter. Looks like they're trying to keep her on the left side. Michael, she gains shot.
Yeah, good job by Patrick. Really just being patient, taking what the defense gives her there.
Moreau with it now. 10 on the shot clock, 20 in the game on the game clock. Harris picks it up on the near turnover. Patrick with 5 on the shot clock now. Harris going to jag it from downtown and just rims out. But Moreau picks up the rebound. Looks like she might have been contacted on her way up. And a good scrap for the ball. That's going to be Varsity Blues ball. 8 seconds to go, so they will have the final possession of the quarter. And it looks like number 14 for the Varsity Blues has been worn. Coach Clark wondering since when they've started handing out warnings instead of technicals. I'm not sure what the warning was for. Mike, maybe you heard something?
No, I'm not sure about that one.
3 to go now. Shot from three-point land. That one rims out. And no further attempts could be made in this quarter. So a high-scoring quarter, Mike. Very high-scoring. Much higher than we've seen as of late. Anyways, Lady Bees with a 25-23 lead so far.
Yeah, coming into this game, I was a little bit concerned of where the Lady Bees were going to get their scoring without their leading scorer. At least one of the leading scorers in OUA was Sasha Polacek, but they've shown no problem. They're getting scoring from all over the place. Danielle Harris has really stepped out. Jenna Davidson, Kristen Patrick's doing a good job. All across the board, they're getting scoring. Everybody's stepping up to fill that void. Mike Clark's got to be very impressed with his young Lady Bee team tonight.
Yeah, just like you said, Mike, it looks like the message is loud and clear for the Lady Bees. They need to find scoring from other places, and it looks like Mike Clark has just told his players to be a lot more aggressive. We've seen a lot more driving into the lane so far, and it seems to be paying off so far. They've got a 2-point lead so far, and again, this is one of the highest scoring quarters that I've seen out of the Lady Bees in a long time. Nobody in any kind of foul trouble just yet either, with the exception of number 14 for the Varsity Blues, Amanda Lozo, who received a warning as that first quarter came to an end.
That Lady Bees already at 25 points. They only average 61 a game, so they're almost halfway there, only through one quarter.
We get a good look at the Varsity Blues bench. Just getting some instruction from Michelle Belongo.
Here, Toronto Varsity Blues. Right now, the coach has to be telling you that you gotta take the 3-point shot away from this Lady Bee team. They're hot from 3-point land. You gotta make sure you get a hand up, make them drivers, and then once you get them to be drivers, you gotta have early help side. It's gotta be a team effort to try and slow down this Lady Bee team.
Well, one of the issues that the Lady Bees were facing last night is that they were taking on a Ryerson Ram squad that had a pretty significant advantage in size. This University of Toronto team, a little bit smaller, a little more comparable to that of the Lady Bees, so they haven't been dominated as much inside as they were early on or throughout the game last night against the Rams. So another plus for the Lady Bees, they can get their top shooters in because they don't need to worry about the contact of the big bodies inside as we're ready to reset here in the second quarter. On the court for the Lady Bees to start this second quarter, we're going to have Danielle Harris, Aaron Simpson, Emma McCole, Avery Moreau, and number 21 Emily Timshaw as the Varsity Blues are just doing. As you can see on your screen, I'm Kirby Johnson with
Mike Hall. We're happy to have you with us. If you're just tuning in, Lady Bees hanging on to a two-point lead. It's 25-23 as we're set for second quarter action live from the Ben Avery Gymnasium. Lady Bees coming off a big win last night against the Rams. Looking to carry that momentum over into tonight's contest. As we're underway.
Well, it looks like the Varsity Blues are still in that 2-3 zone.
Pass cross court from Simpson to Moreau. Moreau picks up her dribble. She's in a bit of trouble. Gets it to Tim Chuck. He drives towards the net. Nice ball with the left hand. Looks like she might have lost the handle, but it falls right through.
Yeah, nice top by hoop. Tim Chuck. Top hoop there by Tim Chuck.
Just looks like she turned and kind of put that one up, but sometimes that's all it takes. Mike has Lozo with a quick response. Harris with the ball facing three Varsity Blues standing at center court. She finds her way around, almost gets fouled.
Good job by Harris breaking that press right there. Looks like it's going to be out of bounds back to the Toronto Varsity Blues as the substitution gets in again.
So it's Stratton back in, I believe, taking the place of number 7, Julie Longhour. As we get minutes and point production in that first quarter.
Yeah, Stratton had 8 points on 3-for-5 shooting.
Nice pass inside to Lozon, tries to spin it off the glass. Harris might get here for a fast break opportunity. That's great speed from Harris, creating some distance. And the foul! I'm not sure what that foul was for, Mike, but great finish. Good job by Daniel Harris. We talked in other broadcasts about how difficult it could be to get yourself slowed down as you're trying to go up on that layup at full speed. Good job by Harris, good composure, and she's fouled, so she's got an opportunity for three.
Like you said, great job by Daniel Harris. I think the referee saw maybe a little bit of a bump in the back when she was going up. Referees are very, they like to key on protecting players, especially in a situation like that. We saw last night a couple times with some full court layups with a couple players getting taken out and getting injured. So referees like to really do a good job protecting players in situations like that.
That's a good point, Mike. And we do have the protective matting at the end of the gyms here, but again, it only does so much. With it, looking to set things up, takes it up top. Ball into Lozo once again, looking left. That's a nice pass off the spin. That one rolls out, rebounded by Moreau.
Great find by Lozo right there. Unlucky not to come away with 2 points on that one. Lady V's did not see the cutter there by Toronto.
Simpson calling for some help on her left side. She finds Harris. Shot clock inside 10 once again. Kicks it back to Simpson, pass inside to Timchuk. She's got three, and she's going to get called for the travel. Looks like the feet might have shifted a little bit.
She had three defenders on there, on her right there.
Coach Clark letting Simpson know that he wants that ball into Timchuk in the post, not necessarily cutting towards the basket. Going to work on some one-on-one as the jumper from Lewin off the mark. Offensive rebound by the Varsity Blues. Yet another one, and we're going to have a jump ball.
Varsity Blues hit, doing a good job in the offensive glass. They just got to do a little bit extra and stand in and knock down some easy chip shots under the rim. They're leaving a lot of points out there right now.
Well, fortunately for the Lady Bees, that's the case as the substitution has them at the court. Or Devin Avery's back in the game, sorry.
Well, that's a great find right there. Unlucky not to come away with the finish, but she's going to head the line for a chance to cut into this 4-point Lady Bee lead.
That's Amanda Lozo at the line. Third year student studying French linguistics and human geography from New Westminster, BC. So 0-for-2 on free throws. Good box out by Tim Chuck.
Yeah, good job by Tim Chuck right there. That's what Lady Bees are going to have to do. They're going to have to get bodies on girls, try and do a better job on their own defensive glass.
Devin A. Bryce with an interesting pass. Might have thought Tim Chuck was going to cut there. Pass intercepted.
Like Jenna Davidson is getting ready to get back into this game. 3-point threat for the Lady Bees.
Lead cut back down to two as Danielle Harris finds Devin A. Bryce approaching half. Attempts to split a couple defenders, a bit too aggressive.
Yeah, a little bit lucky there.
Falcon went to either player here. This one's going to come against number 23, Vanessa Brathwaite.
The key to breaking a zone like this is being patient and under control. Kristen Patrick Danielle Harris, but they've done a good job taking what the defense gives them. It's when you get going a little bit too quick is when that zone is going to give you trouble, and that's going to lead to turnovers. So Lady V's got to get back to being patient, breaking that zone.
Very animated coaching staff on the U of T. We've seen three or four assistant coaches standing up at various points in time giving instruction to the players. As we're back underway. Danielle Harris with it now. We've got just inside 7.5 to go in the first half of play. Danielle Harris loses the handle and that's her dribble. And Tim Chuck also losing the handle. Look of frustration on her face as U of T once again with a chance to tie. That's a nice interception by Jenna Davidson. And she quickly hands over the duties of point guard to Danielle Harris.
That's a good job by Lady Bees getting into the high post, but when Tim Chuck catches, she's got to know that she's got to have defenders collapsing on her quick, so she's got to make a quick decision, swinging the ball to an open player.
And a long attempt by Jenna Davidson, just rims it, rebounded by the Varsity Blues, and back the other way now with Stratton.
Well, that's what you call in the basketball world as a heat check right there.
Wide open look at three, high arcing shot. And Vanessa Wallace is off the mark.
Another good rebound by Tim Chuck. She's doing a job on defensive glass right now.
Good ball move by Lady Bees. There's that pass inside from Bryce to Tim Chuck. But that one was blocked and it bounces. Was that off of number 13, Rachel Spider?
Either that or Flo might have got on it. Either way, great job by the Lady Bees. 31-27 now, just over 6 minutes to go in the half.
One might make its way onto the missed plays of the day. Stratton's on his left in the corner. He's got away from Bryce. Puts up a nice second shot at three. And that one drops through. We've got a timeout now. Called by Laurentian Lady Bees head coach Mike Clark as the lead now at 4 points for the Lady Bees. Done a good job over the past 12 minutes, but that long three-point attempt might be just what the University of Toronto Varsity Blues need to get themselves back in this game. Sorry, scoring out 31-29. It's only a two-point lead.
Yeah, if you're the Varsity Blues right now, you got to feel fortunate about how you're only down 2 points. The Lady Bees have come out red hot, put in 31 points. But if you're Toronto, you got to feel very fortunate. You're only down 2 points. You haven't played your best basketball, but you're still right in this game.
That's absolutely it, Mike. And as you touched on earlier, it looks like the Varsity Blues are maintaining that form of being one of the best offensive rebounding teams in the country. They just aren't able to put those second opportunity points back. I don't know if there's a statistic for that we can look up, but they really need to start making those down. They probably have a pretty healthy lead right now. And most of those second opportunities, or second chance opportunities, are coming nice and in close underneath the basket. They just need to find a way to get those bounces and make them start dropping. We're going to look at Coach Mike Clark in the background there. That's assistant coach Katie Goggins, who gave several years of service to Laurentian University. Putting up some good numbers over the course of her illustrious career as a Lady Bee. As we hear the sound of the buzzer. Players set to retake the court following the timeout. 6:07 to go in the first half. It's OUA basketball on ECM TV. Varsity Blues. We've got Stratton, Brathwaite, number 9, Vanessa Wallace, Molzo, as well as number 13, Rachel Sider. On the Lady Bees, we've got Davidson, Scott, Harris, Bryce, and DeFloe. So Harrison getting some big minutes, but a sloppy pass as Evan A. Bryce, and fortunately losing the handle on that one. Was, Right, so that's cleared up. Ball inbounded. Danielle Harris facing a bit of pressure once again. Good pass to Devin A. Bryce, breaking that pressure. Going right towards the rack again, slashing through a couple defenders. Just rims out. Fighting hard for that offensive rebound, manages to grab it. Finds Mary Scott, open look at three. Scott puts that up, and that one's good. Nice shot by Mary Scott, lead up to five, back to the Lady Bees.
A great extra passing there by the Lady Bees. Good job by Devin A. Bryce, breaking that zone, going hard to the rim. Unlucky not to come away with that finish, but she got the ball alive, and led to a wide-open three-pointer for Mary Scott to get this lead back to five for the Lady Bees.
Oh, a huge slot by Devin A. Bryce. Get that garbage out of here, she says.
Very impressive. Meeting that one at the summit and sending it out of bounds. Great job. That's the one. Blocks like that really get the bench into it, really get the crowd into it. That's a momentum swinger.
They really do. And a good crowd in attendance here to watch Lady Bees take on the Varsity Blues. 11 on the shot clock now for the University of Toronto after that shot clock by Bryce. Open look at three now. Stratton with five on the shot clock, puts up the three, and that one rolls in.
Stratton doing a great job right now. She's got a quiet 15 points already in this game. She's doing a great job for Toronto.
Lady B setting things up with Mary Scott, putting it to Bryce, finding Harris on the left side. Skip pass across to Davidson, three-pointers up, and rattles in and out. Devin A. Bryce fighting hard for another offensive board, but that one's off her forearm and out of play.
Yeah, unlucky for Davidson not to come away with that one. She got a nice-looking shot, very technical, very in rhythm. That one was halfway down. Unlucky she didn't get that one.
And inside five now in the first half. Varsity B's back on offense, still facing that two-point deficit. The Lady B's been hanging on to that for the majority of this game. Slightly lower scoring than the first quarter that we saw. And a pass inside rejected by Mary Scott. That's a good active hand, but the ball finds Stratton, and she puts up a three. Varsity Blues now with the lead. That's 35-34. Stratton's starting to heat up now. She's got 18 points in the first half.
A quiet 18, eh?
Very quiet.
Yeah, Lady B's got to do a better job. Keen on her. She's handling the bulk of the load for Toronto offensively. They got to do a better job taking her out of her rhythm, because right now she's red hot.
Devin A. Bryce fouled on the rebound attempt. It's going to be Lady B basketball. Setting up this inbound play. Someone's going to have to pass it in. That'll be Danielle Harris. Pass inside to Mary Scott, gets a shot off. And a full shot clock there, Mike, but they elected for the quick attempt for Mary Scott to win.
A good flash back to the ball by Mary Scott, but like I said, a little bit of a quick shot. Wouldn't have been a bad idea to take it out, set up quality possession, but they got another chance at it now.
Pass to DeClos on the inbound, finding Devin A. Bryce. BDBs now with 20 on the shot clock, 4 in the quarter. Nice passing by the Lady Bees. That's a nice play. Harris to Bryce, and then inside to DeClos with up and off glass.
Great job by Bryce in the high post. That's what you're looking for out of a high post in a zone. You want to catch the ball, turn, face, and then find a cutting teammate that's wide open.
Three-point attempt by the Varsity Blues off the mark. Rebounded by Stratton yet again. And Mary Scott, or Emma DeClos fouled, sorry, by Varsity Blues number 13, Rachel Sider, as she pulled down that rebound.
36-35, 3:39 to go in the second quarter. It's been a good back and forth play. Both teams making runs. Lady B's got up to a little bit of a lead, but great job by Toronto. Sticking with it, climb back into this game.
Good job by Harris to draw that double team and opening up Devin A. Bryce. As Davidson gets a look at three. That one's off glass and rims out.
Had to put a little bit too much art on that. Good contest by Toronto. A better job on Jenna Davidson.
Lady B's with a one-point lead. Varsity Blues on the basketball. Nice pass inside. Rejected by Emma DeClos. Fast break opportunity with Davidson on it. Finding Danielle Harris. And that was an interesting defensive play.
Yeah, it looked like Danielle Harris got tripped, but I guess they were saying maybe it was unintentional.
Yeah, it looked
so
like
ball out to the Lady B's, but even if it was unintentional, it was still a foul.
Yeah, it looked like Jasmine Lewin just kind of threw her right leg in the way of the Lady B player, and the ball ended up out of bounds.
Bit of a surprising call, but oh well.
Oh well is right. Four fouls for the University of Toronto Varsity Blues, only one for the Lady B's. So a good, clean game so far, and I think a lot of that has to do with the fact that the Varsity Blues aren't getting the ball under the net. The Lady Bees don't have to hack and be too aggressive in order to try and stop the Varsity Blues. The shots are coming from mid to long range, so the Lady Bees are able to get some possession and some shots without needing a foul.
That's a great point, Kirby. Lady Bees doing a really good job keeping Toronto on the perimeter. But then Jill Stratton's doing a good job taking what Lady V's are giving her, and she's got 18 points already. So Lady V's, if they can just do a little bit better job on Stratton, they could be maybe in a position to run away with this one.
Yeah, very dynamic player Stratton is so far tonight anyway. She's been putting the ball on the court. She hasn't been shy to drive, and she's been hitting shots from long range. So she's really been the catalyst, I guess, the main event for this U of T squad. And you're right, the Lady V's are going to need to do something in order to contain her. You get a look at Jenna Davidson hydrating herself. just over 3 minutes to go in the first half. Suffering from a couple audio problems here, folks. We apologize for that. So we're ready to get set once again. It's going to be Devin A. Bryce to inbound. Lady Bees with 21 on the shot clock. Adrian Moreau in the game. Another dangerous shooter. Nice play inside. That's such a quick play. Nice. Sorry, Mike, go ahead.
Yeah, great find by Devin A. Bryce there, but it looks like... Oh, I'm sorry. It looked like they were going the other way, but they're just going to go huddle. Great job by Emma DeClove. That was a great cut. I'm lucky not to come away to the finish, but she has a chance right here to extend the Lady V lead. And makes good on the first.
First free throw on a wire. Lady V's restoring that one-point lead. Two-point lead, excuse me. Set to check in for the Varsity Blues. Julie Longauer once again. Second shot's good. She'll get to check in now. Going to take the place of Vanessa Wallace. First-year student getting some minutes tonight here at the Ben Avery Gymnasium.
Looks like Lady V's are going to try and put a little bit of full-court pressure on, but good job by Toronto breaking that with ease.
And you can hear down on the Lady V's bench, Sasha Polishuk running the cheers and getting that team pumped up. Not a lot of these Lady V's getting too many minutes tonight, but Polishuk making sure they're well in the game and still supportive of their squad. It's great to see that from the leader on your team. As the Varsity Blues get a shot off as the shot clock was expiring, that's Lewin for two. Devin A. Bryce corralling a pass that was nearly over her head. Dishes to Harris on the offensive side of half. Moreau puts the ball on the ground. One dribble, then Harris with the pass inside to Bryce. Can't handle that one. And fast break the other way for the Toronto Varsity Blues now. And that one rims out. And that's a foul by Mary Scott all over the back of the Varsity Blues player on that attempt.
Looked like Danielle Harris might have had a chance to step in for a charge. That's a tough play to make, though.
So at the line for the Varsity Blues, that's Christina Menton, I do believe. That's number 11, Mike. Yep.
That's a nice Dutch name.
So, back the other way now for the Lady V's. Danielle Harris and Aaron Simpson set to check back in. Moreau cutting to the corner, pass inside to Bryce. She's triple teamed and has the ball stripped, but she recovers. Goes baseline inside to DeClos. DeClos off the rim, pulls down her own rebound. Got a fresh shot clock. Bounce pass. Got a three in the key call. Coach Michelle Belanger screaming at the officials until she got that call.
Tough not to come away with the finish there by DeClos. But good job by Toronto Varsity Blues there. They're doing a good job in that zone. Really collapsing on the high post there. Devin A. Bryce had no time to make that play. Almost led to a turnover.
So Simpson taking the place of Adrian Moreau. University of Toronto gaining half. Inside 2 minutes now.
Knotted at 38. Been a good back and forth game. Both teams making runs. Stratton with the fadeaway. That's just off the mark.
Yeah, it looked like Devin A. Bryce might have got a hand on that one as the Lady Bees are back the other way now inside two. Good Mary push. Scott with another look at three. She's fat. Oh, no basket. She's going to get called for the travel as she set her feet.
Yeah, Mary Scott's got to do a better job getting set, getting shot ready there. It's a careless turnover for the Lady Bees.
It looked like she had a little bit of time as well. Pass over the head of Emma DeClos, finding the Toronto player in the corner. Lewin driving baseline, kicks it out to Longauer, who drives in. Tough shot off balance, follows up and pulls down her own offensive rebound. Nice play by Longauer to keep this sequence going for the Varsity Blues. And we're going to have a travel now, so Longauer's efforts wasted by Jasmine Lewin's careless feet.
It looked like Lewin might have traveled on her first drive baseline. Got a little bit ahead of herself. Sorry, Kirby.
That's okay. Danielle Harris with a bit of pressure from the Varsity Blues, but they get over half anyways. Devin A. Bryce finds Mary Scott in the corner. She puts up another three. That one's well heavy. And it looked like Emma DeClos just tried to slap that one to a teammate, but picked up by Stratton, who's going to drive the other way now. And that's Lewin on the baseline. No good. Pulled down by Mary Scott.
Good rebound right there by Mary Scott.
And a good job to keep the ball away from the Varsity Blues players. Kept it up in the air, away from any reaching hands. Another turnover, though, by The Varsity Blues picked off by a long hour.
Yeah, Devonay Bryce getting a, sorry, Kirby, Devonay Bryce getting a little bit ahead of herself right there. Under 50 seconds to play, it's not a bad idea to just get the possession, slow it down, and try and get a quality possession and try to get this lead going into halftime. No need to rush.
Devonay Bryce drawing a foul. That was the same play that the Varsity Blues ran last time, but Lou went off the mark once again, and that will be the fifth foul, sending Devonay Bryce to the line.
Yeah, not a heads-up foul there by Toronto. That one's going to go against number 22, Alana Garner.
Yeah, you can't be too happy with that if you're the U of T coaching staff. That's a foul that doesn't need to be made at this point in the quarter, and you're only applying full-court pressure. You know, it's not the ideal time for a foul, especially if you're going to send player to the line.
Yeah, allow the player to walk the entire length of the court with the clock stop and try and get this lead back. Less than ideal.
Paid off on the first free throw, however. Devonay Bryce off the mark, and the U of T Varsity Blues will have a good chance to kill the majority of the clock that remains in this first half as Devonay Bryce goes 0 for 2 from the line. We're tied at 38, with 21 to go. 17 on the shot clock. Longauer with it. Finds Garner. That one over to Stratton. Looked at three, but ball to Lewin on the line. Shot clock inside 10. And Stratton drives in. Another two for her. She's got 20 now. 7 seconds for the Lady Bees.
Great ball movement by Toronto Varsity Blues.
And that one picked off. Lady Bees will have about a second.
Surprise Mike Clark not electing to take a timeout right now and draw something up. Oh, there he goes.
He definitely heard you, Mike.
Yeah, I'll take a timeout, he says nonchalantly. Yeah, Mike Clark going to now have the opportunity to draw up a last second play. Literally last second, only 1 second on the clock. You're going to have to get something up really quick. Enough time to have feet set, get something up. Don't necessarily need a tip, but you got to be quick with it.
So 1 second to go. We see the men's basketball teams make their way into the change room. As they'll make their preparations. We remind you, immediately following the broadcast of the Lady Bees and Varsity Blues women's game, we've got live coverage of the Laurentian Voyageurs men's basketball team taking on the University of Toronto men's basketball team. The Voyageurs coming off that huge win last night with that buzzer beater by Manny Pasquale, which is something we've seen quite a few times at Ben Avery Gymnasium, but it never gets old. Very exciting finish from that game, and the Voyageurs looking to carry that over from last night. And I believe U of T took on York last night, Mike?
Yeah, and York was able to come away with that victory. So this game is still major for Toronto. Toronto sitting at the bottom of the OUA East, but still right in striking distance.
So with that victory last night, the Voyageurs now sitting at a 500 record on the season. I believe that lifted them to 6-6 with that victory last night.
Yeah, big victory for LU. Great job snapping that little mini losing streak, getting back on the right foot. Looked like the Voyageurs that we saw early in the season, in the 2012 portion of the season.
So a York victory in combination, 1 second to go here in the half as Harris to inbound. Davidson, probably your best choice for the three-pointer, Mike, but just no time, and she was covered a little bit closely. But as I was saying, Voyageurs lost tonight in combination with a York Lions win would result in a tie between those two teams with the matchup coming between them in the very near future. So some exciting stuff coming together in the OUA. So that's it for the first half. Score at halftime, 44 the Varsity Blues, 38 for the Lady Vs. So a two-point deficit faced by the Lady Vs heading into halftime, Mike.
Yeah, if you're Mike Clark, you got to be happy about the way your team has come out to play with the absence of Sasha Paul.
Kristen Patrick has a quick three-pointer put up by the Varsity Blues to retake the lead. Quick pass up court from Patrick to Moreau. She gets bumped. And she's going to get called for the offensive foul. So a good start in that they got their first 2 points, Mike, but after that they've got a three-pointer and a turnover. Varsity Blues bringing it back the other way now, getting things set up.
Going to be important for the Lady Vs to really try and lock down in this third quarter.
And ball thrown towards the out-of-bounds line. Nice save by Leanne Bailey, kept in to Rachel Sider, who puts up a three-point attempt off the side of the net as Danielle Harris streaking down the court looking for a pass from Patrick. She's only able to find Moreau. Ball eventually finds Patrick in the corner. Inside now to Emma Duclos.
Oh, just off the mark there, but good job to stick with it. It's going to be a jump ball. Referee's quick on the whistle. Ball's going to go back to Toronto Varsity Blues.
So it's going to be Leanne Bailey to inbound now. And calmly bringing the ball across half is Alana Gardner. Varsity Blues getting things set up in the offensive zone. Pass swung right through the middle of the key, and that three-pointer rims out.
Great fight underneath by Emma DeClos. Good job to come away with that one.
That was a good tussle for the ball, and that's right. Did a good job to come away without avoiding the jump ball call. Danielle Harris waiting for things to get moving for the Lady Bees. Swings it to Patrick on the side. Uses the screen from Timchuk. Opens up Timchuk. Now she mishandles the ball. Moreau takes a bump from behind. They've got two on the shot clock. Moreau's got to heave up a long attempt. That one's not going to make it to the net. So an unlucky sequence of bad bounces for the Lady Vs and mishandling the ball, and that's another turnover early in the second half.
Yeah, Lady Vs got to be careful here. They need to pick up their focus and intensity here. They don't want to come out soft and let this very talented Toronto team run all over them.
Three-point attempt, that one in and out, and we're going to have a foul on number 13, Rachel Sider, as she was all over the back of Emily Timchuk on that rebound attempt.
Yeah, good job by Timchuk, again getting a body. As we see a substitution with the end of the game.
Yeah, a long hour set to check back in. First minutes for her in the second half. She'll take the place of Rachel Sider. So still a very close game here, a little bit slow to get going. We've had a few points here in the second half, but Lady V's looking to continue to match the intensity of this Varsity Blues team without the likes of their all-star point guard, Sasha Polishuk. They've done a good job so far. Excellent work in the first half. Some secondary and even tertiary scoring coming from the Lady V's. But they'll need to keep that going for the duration of this game if they hope to come away with some points tonight. Another missed offensive opportunity for the Lady V's as the Varsity Blues back on offense. And ball in the corner now. Alana Gardner with the three-point attempt. That one's off the mark. And hitting the floor hard is Jill Stratton. Got bumped by Moreau as Longhour with a nice look at three, and that one's on the mark.
Yeah, so they deserve that one. Lady V's were really scrambling there on defense. Toronto was aggressively moving the ball, unselfishly finding open teammates, and then attacking the offensive glass. Another second possession for Toronto. Those are really starting to add up for the Varsity Blues.
So a six-point lead now. That's the biggest one of the game as Emily Timchuk cuts quickly into that with a nice mid-range jumper. That's for 2 points.
Toronto swinging the ball around the perimeter. That's a good move there.
Timchuk fighting for the rebound now. We've got a jump ball. That's going to be Lady V's basketball. And a bit of rough stuff after the play as Timchuk crashes to the court surface. And Aaron Simpson's going to check back in. She'll take the place of Kristen Patrick. So some quick substitutions by both coaches early on in the second half.
And Lady V's got to pick up the intensity here. Toronto's come out pretty quick, pretty aggressive out of halftime.
As DeClos waits for Aaron Simpson to catch up, ball with Harris, now guarded closely by Stratton, not giving her anything.
Foul away from the ball.
Looks like it's coming against Toronto. And that's Lozon picking up another foul. That's the same official who issued her the warning in the first half, and Michelle Belanger wisely going to get her out of the play right now as Leisha Van Kempen checks in. And in addition to that, the Lady V's will send number 14, Rachel McLean, out onto the court. She'll take the spot of Emily Timchuk for now.
Van Kempen had a solid first half, 4 points and four rebounds for the Varsity Blues.
So lead cut down to two now after that last play. Stratton with it, dribbling to her right. Gets some good penetration, but she crashes hard to the floor. A fearless play, knowing that she's probably going to not have her feet under when she comes back down. She's going to head to the foul line, though, for a couple free shots.
Yeah, dynamic talent. She had 20 points in the first half. That's half of her team's points. Laurentian had to do a better job keying on her. She is almost single-handedly taking it to this Lady V team.
Well, 20 first-half points, that's a remarkable figure for Stratton. A first-year student at U of T as well. So definitely a beneficial addition to this U of T squad.
And unable to come away with either.
So So another opportunity for the Varsity Blues. Quick hands by Devin A. Bryce, almost knocked that one away. And another pass gone astray, picked up by Devin A. Bryce. Good composure from her to not pick up her dribble and get herself caught.
Yeah, good collapsing defense by Voyageurs there, leading to the turnover. Nice pass, but wild shot attempt there by Rachel McLean. 44-46 in favor of the Varsity Blues right now. Under 6 minutes to go in this third quarter now.
So Varsity Blues back on offense. Long hour with that beautiful pass inside to a wide open teammate. That one finding Van Kemp, and it's on the three-point line now. Garner looking to get it inside. And skip pass picked off by Danielle Harris. Good anticipation knocking that one away. 11 seconds on the shot clock.
Yeah, good read by Harris breaking that one up.
Both teams with a couple fouls. Just inside 6 minutes to go in the third quarter. This is OUA basketball on Eastlink TV. And a quick inbound play, and that one rims out. Rebounded by the Varsity Blues. Another offensive board for them as Stratton pump fakes clean around Devin A. Bryce. Puts it up off glass. And rebound tipped from McLean into the hands of Danielle Harris, who finds the streaking Devin A. Bryce back in the other direction. Devin A. Bryce looking to bank that off the U of T player, unable to do that. Back now the other way, go the Varsity Blues. It's Long Hour with it, driving right towards the net. She finds Garner, and nice patience and step underneath. She's up off glass for 2 points. This lead now at 6 points, the biggest of the game for the Varsity Blues.
Lady V's got to maintain their composure here. Turnovers really starting to add up. They had 16 turnovers in the first half.
Yeah, that's bit of a startling number, Mike, for any team at any level. Got to start taking better care of the basketball. A lot of that has to do with the absence of Sasha Polshuk. She is known to have a few turnovers per game, but that's normally when she's just getting herself into the flow of things. So the Lady Bees, a few careless passes, especially early on in the game when they were trying those long cross-court passes to try and break the press of the U of T Varsity Blues. But yeah, that's definitely something they'll have to work on in order to keep themselves in competition in this game. And excuse me, that's only a four-point lead for the Varsity Blues as it stands right now. Open look at three. That one's going to miss well to the right. That's Jasmine Lewin with the air ball.
Somebody might have opened the door here at Ben Avery.
So another second chance opportunity. That rebound picked up and finds Leanne Bailey. She's up off for another 2 points.
Yeah, Varsity Blues picking up where they left off. They had 9 offensive rebounds in the first half. And they've already got 3 or 4 already early in this second half.
Got another foul call. Looked like the Lady V player may have been sort of cornered out of bounds, but picking up the foul. I think that one's against number 12, Leanne Bailey, maybe picking up the foul. Yep, that's her third of the game, so a bit of trouble for her as we're only midway through the third quarter of play.
Jenna Davidson back in the game, giving Devin A. Bryce a quick break. Mike Clark's going to want her offensive impact on the game.
So some good passing, getting the ball inside, but Rachel McLean chips it back out. Nice pass inside to DeClos. She's up off glass for 2. And back the other way come the Varsity Blues, looking to keep extending this lead. The Lady V's doing a good job hanging on. Looks like the Varsity Blues are ready to start pulling away. Good ball movement around the perimeter, looking for something inside. They find Long Hour wide open. Harris had to hustle all the way across the three-point line to get a hand in the way of that shot.
Lady V's got to have better awareness in that zone and knowing where the Varsity Blues offensive players are.
And it looked like Patrick is ready to take off with that one, just unable to do so. And it's the Varsity Blues with a fresh shot clock, a wide open look at 3. Nobody on the wide open. Melissa Frederick getting her first action of the night for the Varsity Blues.
Yeah, more miscommunication at the bottom of that zone. Mike Clark's got to shut that up if he expects to stay in this game for much longer.
Inside 4 to go now. It's Harris on the basketball. 4-point lead for the Varsity Blues. Harris using a couple screens to get herself open. DeCole swings it to an open Patrick. Oh, she might have had a chance at 3, but just slipping on the play. Coach Clark thought there might have been a foul on that drive. No call. Back the other way now come the Varsity Blues.
Yeah, I think Toronto might have caught a break there. It looked like Patrick got clearly hit on the arm on that drive to the hoop.
Good rebound by the Lady Bees. Keeping a hand on that is McLean fighting hard for it. We've got a jump ball. That's going to be Varsity Blues basketball. So we've got Coach Belanger of the Varsity Blues arguing that it was a travel. We've got Coach Mike Clark arguing that there was a foul on the play. Coach Clark's got to be careful because, as we know, this referee isn't afraid to give out technicals.
Yeah, we saw that last night like you alluded to before, Kirby.
So ball to be put in play now. A fresh shot clock. Long Hour getting open on the inbound. And a foul picked up. This one coming against DeClos. That's DeClos' third foul, so she's in a bit of trouble now. And it looks like she's going to check out right now. Mandy Costantino getting her first action of the weekend. And long hour looking around, hoping that none of these about 200 fans in the Ben Avery saw that air ball on the free throw attempt.
Now the door's still open.
We all saw it, Julie. Settles in for her second attempt. Both teams sitting on three fouls. Second one rims out just short. Good battle for the rebound, but the Lady V's come away with it. It's Patrick across half. With a bit of speed, looks like she wants to take it herself. Wide open look at three is Davidson, and she's good again. Cutting the lead back down to one.
Great job by Kristen Patrick right there. Really forcing the issue. Under control, driving it in, drawing the defense in, turning around, finding a wide open Jenna Davidson. She's not going to miss many of those.
Well, Davidson just seems to know when it's a key time for her team. Her Voyageurs team needed a couple points, and she steps back and hits another three. Great job by her to keep her team close in this one. Inside three to go now. DeClos finds Harris at top of three. Guarded closely by Frederick. We've got an off-the-ball foul. Looks like this one might come against Patrick.
Yeah, Patrick.
Called on the push. It's going to be going back the other way now. 2:43 to go. Score 50-49. That's Patrick's second foul. No points on the night just yet, but she's done a good job controlling the ball for the Lady D's and helping to set up the offense.
Yeah, she's done a good job filling in for the absent Sasha Polachuk, being the team leader on the floor.
So setting things up now for the Varsity Blues, we've got Jasmine Lewin. She finds Frederick, who looks inside, dishing that one to Menton, also getting her first minutes of the night. There's an open look for Lewin, and she knocks that one down. Lead extended back to three now.
Wow, great unselfish play by Toronto. Looked like Toronto might add a layup, but decided to just dish it out to yet another wide-open Toronto Varsity Blue.
Yeah, a couple nice looks underneath, but Lewin ending up with the basketball and makes a count. Big block from behind, that one by Christina Menton. Making full use of that 5'10" frame, getting a hand on that shot attempt, and back now come the Varsity Blues. Just about 2 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Lead now with three, wide open Lewin in the corner. And fortunately for the Lady V, she'll make them pay, but it looked like getting a hand in the face of the offensive player. Looked like Danielle Harris might have picked up a foul, but Alicia Van Kempen fighting through that. Yep. And in the face for a couple points, lead now at five.
Monster board by Van Kempen.
So Harris waiting for things to set up. Finds Davidson. And Patrick pump fakes, finds Costantino. She puts up the air ball. Fortunately, that's picked up by Rachel McLean. She's going to get called for the travel as she's fighting to keep a hand on the ball.
Yeah, things just don't seem to be going the Lady V's way right now. They need to calm down, regain their composure. They're only down 5:30 to go in this third quarter.
So Lewin with it once again. Adrienne Moreau set to check in. Thinking about three was Rachel Sider. Looks it off, dishes inside to Van Kempen. And another foul. Van Kempen's going to head to the line, looking a bit sore after that shove. That foul's coming against Costantino. That'll only be her first of the night.
Yeah, Toronto's done a really good job in this third quarter dissecting that Lady V zone. They're pretty much getting what they want when they want right now. Mike Clark's going to have to make some adjustments with this zone.
Moreau checks in for Jenna Davidson. Looks like the Lady V's might be starting to slow down a little bit, Mike. They're playing that scrambly type of defense that we've seen over the past couple nights, but it just doesn't look like they're able to get the hands in the faces like they were last night. A very tough and draining game for the Lady V's last night, and we might be just starting to see some signs of that now as we approach the one-minute mark of the third quarter.
Yeah, a lot of these Lady V's have played a lot of minutes. Might be starting to add up, but it's a long season. This is an important game. You got to regain your composure, maintain your focus. Game still in reach.
Costantino manages to get a tough shot off over the hands of Van Kempen, but that one's off the mark. Voyageurs in a bit of a scoreless drought on their past three or four possessions. They'll need a stop here. Lead now with seven. We're inside a minute to go. 48 seconds, 14 on the shot clock. Varsity Blues on the basketball. Frederick with it. Nice pass inside. Kicking it back out to Lewin. Jasmine Lewin swinging across court to an open sider, and that three-pointer drops. Now, Mike, you got to think, one of the main reasons that this Varsity Blues team is so good at offensively rebounding the basketball, on that last three-point attempt, the player who shot the ball was halfway towards the net by the time the ball had made it to the basket. So great job following up on their shot attempts, and that's got to be a contributing factor to their success on the offensive boards.
Absolutely. That's a great point, Kirby. And it should be noted that the Varsity Blues are going on this impressive run without Jill Stratton on the floor.
That's important to note as well. The top scorer of tonight's game,
getting some much deserved and I'm sure much needed rest at the moment. But her team no worse for wear. They've now extended this lead to 10 points. Lady V's looking to hang on and not allow any kind of buzzer beater type shot as Frederick puts up the three. That one hits the back of the rim and falls out. No foul on the play, so that'll do it for the third quarter. Lady V's close heading into that third, now facing a double-digit deficit. Not the kind of quarter that Coach Clark was looking for.
Yeah, impressive quarter by the Toronto Varsity Blues. They really imposed their will throughout that quarter, really dissected the soft zone of the Lady V's. Lady V's got to do a better job just maintaining focus in that zone and getting back to that scrambly defense that we saw yesterday. They're looking like they're getting a little bit tired. Mike Clark might have to go to his bench a little bit, see if he can try and get a spark and get back into this game.
Yeah, it looks like the Varsity Blues are having little problem at all getting the ball moved around the perimeter, and then they make that check in and check out kind of pass that really opens up that scrambly defense of the Lady Bees, and that's why the Varsity Blues have been able to have so many looks from the perimeter and even from inside. And as you touch, Mike, it looks like the Lady Bees are almost anticipating or expecting those easy layups on those second chance opportunities, but the Varsity Blues are being patient. They're doing a good job waiting until someone gets open a little further away from the basket to get a better look, and they've had great success with that so far, especially in that third quarter. And as it shows on the scoreboard, they've got a 10-point lead. We get a good look at Coach Clark trying to get his players back into this game. And of course, as we mentioned a number of times already tonight, how much would you love for Sasha Polachuk to just lace up the shoes right now and step onto the court?
Yeah, they're really missing Polachuk. Just not necessarily her scoring, but just her leadership ability and her ability to control the pace of the game. Turnovers really adding up for the Lady Bees. They're already at 20, and that's a definite sign that they're missing their point guard, Sasha Polachuk.
Yeah, so they did a bit of a better job controlling the ball in that third quarter, only putting up three turnovers, but still 20 is a huge number in a CIS basketball game. And the Varsity Blues doing a pretty good job controlling the ball. They're only at 11 turnovers, so they're doing a pretty good job taking care of the rock. All right, so if you're enjoying tonight's basketball action, why not try out some Sudbury Wolves hockey? The next OHL broadcast on Easing TV is Sunday, January 20th at 2 p.m. Join us as the Wolves take on the Kitchener Rangers in what promises to be an excellent contest. For a schedule of our televised game coverage this season, please head to eastlinktv.com. Underway here in the fourth quarter, Mary Scott on the basketball. Finds Patrick. Tough layup with the right hand. That one is a bit heavy and bounces away from the hoop. And Lewin drives towards the basket, drawing in a couple of defenders. And a tough scoop shot attempted by Rachel Sider. Michelle Belanger thought there might have been a foul on the play. No call from the officials off that missed shot attempt. Duclos inbounding to Patrick.
Varsity Blues really winning the battle of the glass right now. They have 13 offensive rebounds going. And Laurentian Lady Bees only have 20 defensive rebounds.
Pretty staggering difference there, Mike. And I think you pointed out at the start of the game, the Lady Bees are a minus 7.2 in the rebounding category. I'm not sure if you touched on that already tonight, but some clarification. That means in all games that the Lady Bees take place in, they will normally be out-rebounded by at least seven.
Yeah, definitely a key to the game. LU 39th in the country in rebound margin. Like you said, 7.2 or minus 7.2 a game. And Toronto second in the country in offensive rebounds with 17.1. So that's been a big key to the game and a big key to Toronto's ability to build this 10-point lead.
So for the Varsity Blues at this point in the game, you just need to keep playing with that intensity you're playing with. It looks like they've started to use that that full court press that kind of comes to its peak at half, and Lady V's having a bit of trouble passing through that since they've needed to adjust that a number of different times during the game, as we see a nice play between Patrick and Duclos cutting that lead down to 8 points now, and an open look at three, and might have heard a smack from Patrick on the way by, but Rachel Sider off the mark. Good fight from Duclos to hang on to that, and Moreau did a good job to keep the ball away from the defenders. Ball back the other way now for the Lady V's as Danielle Harris drives to her left.
Good composure by her to,
yeah, exactly,
pull it up.
To slow down. And Patrick, clumsy feet once again. Feet started moving before the arms did.
59-51, 8 minutes, 16 seconds to go in this fourth quarter.
And you can't think it'll be too long before we see Jenna Davidson once again if the Lady Bees can't do much to chip away at this lead. We can sure use the likes of her three-pointing abilities at this point in time as the Varsity Blues content to swing the ball around the perimeter as the shot clock dwindles down to 10 seconds. That pass swatted away by Duclos wisely.
And Harris back with it now. She's got Patrick and Moreau on the left side. Patrick waiting for something to set up, looking for one of her bigs to set a screen. She's got Mary Scott on the left side, stepping up to three. We saw her hit one earlier on. And ball finds Harris. She drives in, up with the right hand, and getting a hand on that one and deflecting it away was Alicia Van Kempen.
That's a good job by Teclo, trying to back down her defender. Drew the double, rather. Dished it out to a wide-open Harris, but Harris electing to drive right back into the teeth of the defense and ended up coming up with nothing but air.
Lozo back in the game now, sitting on two fouls, as well as Jill Stratton. So we'll see if she can continue that hot streak she was on earlier on. I don't know that she has any second half points, Mike, probably given that she didn't play a whole lot of minutes in the third quarter, but she'll look to get going once again.
Yeah, Stratton still at 20. She was at 20 at half, but testament to this Toronto Varsity Blues team that they had their leading scorer on the bench while they went on that run.
Moreau gets a good look at three, picking the ball up off the court. Sends that a bit heavy, and it's an air ball. Good job by Moreau to slow Lewin down as she looked like she had a head of steam. No basket. We've got a travel on the call. You read that one pretty clearly, Mike.
Yeah, you see that a lot in basketball. Pretty easy to point that one out. But Lady Vs, they got to do a better job on offense. Toronto Varsity Blues are really picking up the intensity on defense, taking them out of that fluidity that we saw in the first half that led to that 38-point scoring that we saw in the first half.
Harris driving in once again, gets a shot off. She's fouled on the play. Ball only made it to the underside of the backboard, but she's going to get a good look at two shots here, looking to chip away at this lead once again, as it looks like Simpson's ready to check back in. Simpson's going to come in for Moreau.
Yeah, Danielle Harris has done a good job inserting into the starting lineup tonight in place of injured Sasha Polachuk. She's 5-for-9 from the field, 2-for-5 from the three-point line. She's got 13 points and 3 rebounds on top of that. She's kind of struggled breaking that zone, but she's a first-year guard, so that's going to, you know, it's all a learning process. She's got 5 turnovers, but, you know, big in-game experience for her, a big positive for the Lady Vs moving forward.
So lead cut down to 6 now. We're inside 7 minutes to go. This is OUA basketball on Eastlink TV. I'm Kirby Johnson with Mike Hall. Happy to have you with us as the Lady Vs come away with another turnover. Devin A. Bryce fighting to keep her footing, manages to do so, and gains the zone casually. Nice pass inside. Up off glass. That one won't drop her to Clo. Beautiful play by Devin A. Bryce, however, to gain the zone and set that offensive opportunity up.
Yeah, that was electric. Unlucky not to come away with that finish.
Another travel. This one on Lozo. Still having a hard time with that one official. Substitution now. We've got number 12 checking in for the Varsity Blues. That's Leanne Bailey. And no surprise, coming back out of the game, Amanda Lozo. So putting in a couple more minutes. And checking back out. Lady V's facing that full court pressure yet again. Danielle Harris with the ball. Chipping it back over to Patrick. Looks like the Lady V's have that press pretty much figured out, Mike.
Yeah, they're doing a better job with that. They just need to keep doing a better job on offense, taking what the Varsity Blues give them. They're getting a little bit ahead of themselves. Need to remain patient on the offensive end.
Substitution now again, Julie Longhour checks back in. She'll take the place of Rachel Sider.
You get a look at Kristen Patrick along the baseline, ready to pass it in.
Finds DeClo right away to Harris. Lady V's working that right side as Patrick loses the footing and the ball. Stratton the other way. Also losing the handle, but she manages to pick it up. Longhour now drawing the foul. That one's going to come against number 4, Devin A. Bryce of the Lady V's.
Yeah, Varsity Blues really playing on the front foot right now. Really being aggressive. Not letting their foot off the gas at all. Really trying to finish this game out strong with under 6 minutes to go. Trying to maintain and build on this now 7-point lead.
That's Devin A's third foul. Only one team foul per squad in this fourth quarter, so nothing too chippy just yet. Mike, players playing with a lot of grace, I suppose. Not too rough tonight. As Harris beats that press yet again, but Patrick waiting patiently for the ball. As there's, here comes Davidson, Mike. Didn't think it'd be too long before she checked back in, as Harris has 13 on the shot clock. Patrick for 3. High arcing shot, hits the right side of the rim and falls out.
Yeah, Lady V is really content with just moving the ball around that zone.
Quick pass into the hands of Garner. She loses the handle. And Harris coming away with the interception and the 2 points. So good job by Harris. Some good active hands by her.
Yeah, she's up to 16 points now.
Must be approaching a season high, if not achieving a season high for Danielle Harris. Good night for her so far, but could only be made better if her team could come away with a couple points tonight, Mike. And they've got an uphill battle as they've got a 6 point deficit to overcome. And a
tough foul going against Erin Simpson. She was doing a very good job on Stratton there, taking her out of her comfort zone, moving her feet pretty well, but referee right on top of that one.
A very tough foul, and the shot clock had run down to 3 seconds, and given that there's a foul in the offensive zone, a non-shooting foul, that shot clock's going to jump back up to 14 seconds, so little pressure on the Varsity Blues to rush a play up here. They've got lots of time. Longhour being guarded closely by Davidson, giving her a hard time. Shot clock again down to 3. They're going to have to force something up. Longhour gets a good look at 3. Nice little pick set by number 12, Leanne Bailey, to open up that 3-point attempt, but it was off the mark. And back now the other way comes Danielle Harris. She dishes to Davidson in the corner. Looks at 3, looks it off. Back to Harris. And we've got a foul. Looks like this one's coming against Lewin.
Getting a little bit grabby with Erin Simpson there.
They just got a hand on the arm, and it's going to be Lady V's basketball. And again, the shot clock's going to hop back up to 14 seconds. Got to think that most of these possessions each result in points for the Lady V's as the minutes start to dwindle down. We're inside 5 to go. Harris, good job to keep the ball. Open look at 3. It's right on line, and it rims out on the back part of the net. But offensive rebound by Jenna Davidson. Lady V's with a fresh shot clock. Simpson looking to set things up right in the middle of the court now. Dribbles to her right, gets it going. And the scoop, and that one drops. Assistant coach Chloe Santuzza Sousa up off the bench. Loving every bit of that.
Another foul looks like it's going to go against Erin Simpson. This referee, same referee that called the last one on Simpson. He's right on top of that one as well.
Yeah, second foul for Simpson on tonight. And something we touched on last night as well, Mike. It's late in the game. It's a close game. That's not a foul that really altered the play in any way. I don't know.
Yeah, questionable, but four-point game right now, 61-59, or 57 rather, just over 4 minutes to play.
Too much room for Lewin as she gets a good look at 3. That one rims out, and Devin A. Bryce with another block on the putback attempt, and another jump ball, and this one's going to go to the Varsity Blues, I believe.
Looks like they called a foul, actually. Got him from behind.
Well, Lady V's happier with that. That foul coming against Alana Garner, fourth-year student. That's her third foul tonight, so a few players now with 3 fouls. Each team with 2 players with 3 fouls and 1 player with 2 fouls on the court as it stands right now as Lady V's get over half. Open Devin A. Bryce on the left side, spinning away from a couple guards. And now Jenna Davidson with an open look at 3. Lost the handle a little bit on the shot attempt. That one's up and off the back of the net.
Lady V's have done a good job in the past couple minutes, really picking up their intensity on both ends of the floor. Started with the Erin Simpson. She came in. She's playing good, tough defense on Stratton, although she's been called for a couple fouls, but she still picked up the intensity, and her teammates are really picking up on that.
Another substitution now. Leanne Bailey checking in for Jasmine Lewin. Coach Clark and this official's been getting a lot of attention so far this weekend, going at it yet again. And no problems at all for the Varsity Blues, gaining half. A free path right up the center of the court as Longhour has the ball, 14 on the shot clock. Kicks it to Garner on the left side, and she travels. No argument from the coaching staff on that one. Looked like she wanted to make the pass and then thought about taking it to the rack. Shuffled the feet before the ball hit the court, and that's a travel and a turnover.
Yeah, another good stand for the Lady V's on that one. They got to start capitalizing on the offensive end, though. Only 4 points down. Risky pass to Devin A. Bryce. Another turnover for the Lady V's. They got to get back on defense now.
And back on the offense now come the Varsity Blues, still with that 4-point lead.
Another travel.
Well, that's got to be frustrating for Coach Belanger. We're at a crucial point in this game, and these are high-level elite athletes, and that's such a fundamental thing. That's 2 or 3 in the past couple minutes that we've seen resulting in direct turnovers, and the Lady V's unable to capitalize so far. If there's anything the Varsity Blues can be happy about with those turnovers, it's that the Lady V's haven't made them pay just yet. Another chance, though, right now. Just over 3 minutes to go. Danielle Harris meets a couple Varsity Blues. Good bounce pass around. Finds Devin A. Bryce, and the pass was almost picked off. Jenna Davidson wide open for three and off the rim, but Devin A. Bryce gets up and pulls that down. And a terrible pass after picking up that offensive board right into the hands of Julie Longhour and Michelle Belanger and the U of T coaching staff letting her players know that they need to slow it down and milk this clock right about now.
Yeah, you said it, Kirby. Under 3 minutes to go. This clock is now becoming the Lady V's enemy.
That's another block by Devin A. Bryce.
That's a questionable call as well. Looked like it clearly went off Stratton, but perhaps they thought it could have been a foul. So instead of calling the foul, they decided to give the ball back to Toronto. You see referees do that from time to time.
Oh, and the Lady V's getting caught watching, a little disappointed with that call. And Harris launching Stratton to the floor, but getting the ball.
Yeah, play really starting to pick up in the last couple minutes here, Kirby.
Absolutely. So just over 2.5 to go, 2:31 to be exact, is get a good look at head coach of the Varsity Blues, Michelle Belanger, right in the ear of the official. And complete full court pressure now from the Varsity Blues. Frederick guarding Danielle Harris closely. Lob pass cross court, finds Duclos, swings it to Devin A. Bryce. And Lady V's with some nice passing.
Good composure by the Lady V's.
Bryce with another offensive board and a sweet putback by Devin A. Bryce, picking that one up and scooping it up and under off glass for two. Lead down to one possession. It's a two-point game, 61-59 for the Varsity Blues. 2 minutes to go. Frederick getting some important minutes. We haven't seen her all night. Now she's on the court for the last two.
Well, yeah, I think
another jump ball.
Head coach Belanger was really unhappy with number 22, Atlanta Garner, with those back-to-back travel calls. Really sending a message that that's unacceptable, inserting Melissa Frederick for the first time in the game.
Coach Clark calling a man-to-man defense on this inbound play, telling his players to match up.
That's good defense by the Lady V's there. Good communication.
Stratton straddling the line as an open look from Frederick, and that one's going to dribble in. And, Mike, you saw something on that play.
Wow, instant impact by Frederick. First time in the game like we talked about, and no nerves at all.
Jenna Davidson with the reply. What a shot to respond to that. Another huge three-pointer by Jenna Davidson, and she's keeping her team in this one. Great. Jenna with 20 points on the, Jenna now with the 11 points on the night after that huge three.
Too easy underneath for Toronto. Lead back up to four.
Good job boxing out by Rachel Sider, opening up that opportunity. And Coach Belanger, well out onto the court. The official actually had to pass behind her to get down into the offensive zone for the Lady V's. Harris with a look at three. That one's online, and that one rims out the entire Lady V's bench with a lean back and awe.
Oh, Devin A. Bryce with a good hand from behind.
Devin A. Bryce is having an unbelievable fourth quarter right now. A minute to go. The crowd's getting into it. Two-point game, or four-point game, excuse me.
Harris. Looked like she was going to attack there. Aaron Simpson slowing it down, driving right. She's losing her feet.
Simpson hits the floor. We're going to have a jump ball. Wise play by Simpson. Only five on the shot clock, but the Lady V's able to keep possession. Timeout called by Mike Clark and the Lady V's, so he'll have to draw something up. So ideally only would have been facing a couple points right now, but a big three-pointer by Melissa Frederick extended that lead to 4 points, but the quick reply by Jenna Davidson, absolutely vital for the Lady V's.
Absolutely. Great, great play by Jenna Davidson. Four-point game right now, 47.7. Right now Mike Clark is just trying to get, there's only 5 seconds on the shot clock, so he's going to try and draw up something quick, try and open up one of his shooters or one of his playmakers, either Harris or Aaron Simpson, to try and make a play for a teammate. Got to get a score here, but if you don't, it's all right. Still enough time. Right now, you're trying to get a good look, but then you got to get a stop, too, because it's a two-possession game, so you got to get a stop on defense.
Neither team in immediate foul trouble right now. Both teams with a couple fouls to give inside 48 seconds to go. No individual player in serious foul trouble. A couple players on each squad, as I mentioned earlier, with three fouls apiece. For the Lady V's, that's number 15, Emma Duclos, and number 4, Devin A. Bryce. But again, Devin A. Bryce having an outstanding corner. Just looks like she's all over the place. She's got at least 3 or 4 rebounds in the corner. She's got a steal and 2 blocks. She's having a great quarter so far, and she's going to need that to continue if the Lady V's hope for some last-minute magic.
Yeah, stat sheet filling up for Devin A. Bryce. She's done a good job just really just bringing the energy and being active. has really given our Lady V teammates a lift here in this fourth quarter.
So the Varsity Blues taking the complete timeout as their players take to the court. So it's pressure time here for the Lady V's. Down four, 66-62, sorry. 47 seconds to go, five on the shot clock. Ball gets inbounded to Simpson. The close opened up. She's going to have to jack a shot from downtown. Not even close. And I'm not sure that's what Coach Clark had drawn up. And we've got another timeout now, this one called by the Varsity Blues. So definitely the exact opposite of what the Lady Bees were hoping for there, Mike.
Well, you said it, Kirby. Exact opposite. Got the ball in the hands of Aaron Simpson. That's their playmaker. She's stuck in the corner. She's got to make a play for the teammate. She does not have enough time to pass it to their center, DeClos, well behind the three-point line. She's got to put it on her own shoulders to make a play there for her teammates.
Yeah, I was just going to mention that as well, Mike. When Simpson picked up the ball, she had DeClos right next to her. And then I forget who it was, but it was another one of the bigs off this Voyageurs squad that ended up with the ball that took that shot. It might have been Mandy Costantino even. Yeah, I think it was, who ended up taking that shot from almost half that was nowhere near the basket. So I wonder whether Mike Clark had planned for one of his bigs to shoot it or whether somebody didn't complete their assignment. Either way, that one didn't work out the way the Lady Bees had hoped, and they're still facing a four-point deficit, and now they don't have the basketball. So Eastlink TV News for Sudbury's only truly local news on television. Tune in to Eastlink TV weeknights from Monday to Thursday or catch earlier broadcasts on Eastlink TV on demand. That's Eastlink TV News, Sudbury's truly local news.
So right now for the Lady Bees, it's absolutely paramount that they lock down, really shut down the penetration, have early help side, and then most importantly, get a body on Toronto Varsity Blues and secure that defensive rebound. Because right now, you're down two possessions. So it all starts with this first stop.
Yeah, it's got to be all hands on deck for the Lady Bees now. Some good rotating defense as Simpson's up top to meet Stratton, top scorer in tonight's game so far.
Yeah, if you're Toronto, you want to use this entire clock. And then at the end of the clock, try and get an open shot.
Frederick with it now, moving it back up to Longhour. Doesn't have much, finds Stratton once again, 20 seconds to go.
Offensive foul looks like they're calling. Great job by Simpson drawing that one. Yeah. That's a key turnover.
Simpson showing a lot of veteran leadership here. The third year sports psych student, the Sudbury local, drawing the offensive foul and thus the turnover. Shot clock is off. Lady Bees are down by four. We've got a timeout called by Laurentian.
So right now, 19.1. Still a lot of time. You want to get a quick shot. Doesn't have to be a three. Just a quick quality shot, and then not enough time to let them use the entire shot clock, so you got to go for a steal quickly, and if you don't get it right away, you got a foul, send him to the line. Neither team's in bonus right now, but
which could serve detriment to the Lady Bees. They can foul, but the University of Toronto is going to maintain the basketball until the following foul, in which case they'll head to the free throw line, and then the Lady Bees will have the opportunity for a rebound or to get the ball after the successful shot, but not an ideal position for the Lady Bees right now by any means, Mike.
Yeah, first things first, get a quality shot, then go for the steal. If you don't get it, foul quickly. Still 19.1 seconds, not a ton of time, but still enough time to get back into this ball game.
So the buzzer sounds and the players set to retake the court with 19.1 seconds to go in the fourth and final quarter. Voyageurs doing their final huddle. Again, we remind you, stay tuned immediately following this broadcast at 8 o'clock. We've got the Laurentian Voyageurs men's basketball squad set to take on the University of Toronto Varsity Blues men's team. Voyageurs coming off a big win last night. So look forward to that immediately following this game. Ball inbounded by Danielle Harris. She's setting things up.
Got to attack here.
14 seconds. Ball kicked out to Moreau. Gets a good look at three. That one rims out.
And
rebounded
now
by Stratton, and I'm not sure where the Lady Bees are going.
I guess they're just accepting defeat.
Yeah, Coach Clark must have given them the message to just accept it if they didn't hit that shot. So very anticlimactic finish to this one. The University of Toronto Varsity Blues Lady Basketball team coming away with a 66-62 victory over Laurentian Lady Bees squad that...